Hey guys, welcome to the channel. It's your boy Logan, and today we've got some news for Duel Links. We're gonna head to the meta in a minute, and I'll tell you what's going down and my opinion of that. But first, let us head to the upcoming Forbidden List, which is scheduled for the 8th of December this year. So, the following cards will be limited to one per deck. There you go. Salamene Great Gazelle. Salamene Great Roar. Enemy Controller. Head Judging. Treacherous Trap Hole. There's a reason I can see why this would be on the list. I'm not going to pronounce that. That's a Dark Lord card. And World Legacy Whispers. So, let's cover the one per deck rule. This shouldn't be on it. Gazelle should not be on it. Really, it shouldn't. Reasons being, you need more than one. You need to run more than one in a deck for this thing to work. For its effect to be, like, effective. I think maybe they should take this and put it on two. But okay. As for Roar, Salamene Great Roar, it's a counter trap. I mean, why are you limiting this? This is a counter trap. But that being said, because it's a counter trap, I guess they limiting it to one per deck. Let's go. On the limited two, only two cards per unlimited per deck can be used, included in your deck. Okay, cool. Okay, so this one is just one card, Lady Debug. I mean, when this card is normal, special, or summoned, you can add one level 3 or lower side burst monster from your deck to your hand. Yeah, okay. Let's just put it this way. Why are you special at summoning this here? Unless you, like, you know, comboing into a bigger link. Which is what I see this card being used for most of the time online. And the limited 3 per deck. And since this is, like, 2 per deck, this should... Yeah, okay, 2 per deck, I get it. Now, after a small amount of time to consider, you know, 2 per deck. Gazelle should also be 2 per deck. And so should Roar. I don't think Gazelle and Roar are being treated, quote-unquote, fairly in this one. Limited to 3 per deck. Like, playset. Why is this even on here? Like, limited to 3 per deck. Why? Why is this even on here? We're gonna get to... the real part later. The Salamene Great Circle. Place it. Everybody's already playing this anyway. And you're basically playing two per deck mostly. Because, mom, Link Summoning is awesome and who is basically all you need. Legendary Six Samurai. I'm not even going to pronounce that. Because I'm probably going to fuck it up. And I don't want to do that. Again, playsets. Why? Why are you listing playsets? Okay, fair enough. These are... Okay. And then we have cards that are no longer on the list. Cosmic Cyclone. Fair enough. Everybody only runs one of these anyway. Invocation. Cool. This was on the list. Why was this on the list? Why? Why? It works. Like, okay. Ragged Gloves. I get it. Cool. Its effect is considerably dangerous if it's played in the right hands. But I don't think that this should have even been on the list in the first place. One of the invoker... Invoked fusions. Cool, cool, cool. It doesn't have a freaking effect. Why was this on? What, because it has 3,000 attack? No. Gagaga hit. I remember this being on the list. Whether I'm gonna add it to my actual Yuma deck is still up for debate. I don't think I will. Shinaryu. Shinayu. Squire. That was okay. I mean, when this card is normal special summon, you can summon one Shinayu sword, Spectre sword. Okay, cool. One. This should be limited. This should be definitely limited to two per deck. My opinion on whether that should be limited. Yeah, guess what? This should also be, because working in conjunction with this, yeah, okay, also limited to two per deck. Mechlord Ritual? Why? Necros Ritual? Why? Why? Okay, also, why is this on the deck? Why was this on the ban list? Gen X? Controller? Okay, I guess we can figure out Gen X is a real spam heavy deck. So yeah, those are the cards on the forbidden list and the limited list. But let's get to the updates, and I've got a few things in my head as to who will be in the upcoming Legendary Duelist. Early December, of course, obtain a new Legendary Duelist. A certain character will appear exclusive to the events. What is this? Reigns? Is this Reigns? He doesn't attack straight to the heart. Is this for Reigns? Or is this... is this for Reigns? I don't remember anyone from 5Ds or Sexism. Obtain a legendary duelist. Collect exclusive items to challenge the event exclusive. Here's a direct attack straight to your heart. That could actually be Shay. It could be Shay. I'm not sure. Because if it is, I'm very excited to see that. It's going to be very interesting to see Shay being played online. If that is Shay. Also, Duel Links missions research. Early, probably in the first, week? First week or first 2 weeks. Normally in the first 2 weeks. And then Rio becomes exclusive to the gate. Is no longer an exclusive character. She becomes a gate character. So, all of those people that didn't get Rio the first or second time. Yeah, guess what? Here's a shot. Also, in mid-December, the upcoming events action duel begins. Now, action duels. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. That's another 5Ds thing. Get the UR card, action magic, full turn, plus the super rare card, performer pal, part Naga. I thought part Naga was already in the game. Did they redesign the card or something for the game? Of course, dual capsules. Who doesn't love dual capsules? Those things are freaking awesome. And then, of course, late December, Dark Side of Dimensions, Dual Road. And we will create a bright future together. Is that DSOD a 10? Maybe. Maybe. I don't know. I don't think so. I don't think so. He didn't have any lines in the movie. And then your standard mentions, you know, because, well, yeah. Let me just quickly head over to the meta page. The leaks say that Shay, Virus, and a new character IDs. Yeah, okay, cool. Here's my gripe with this thing. If we're gonna get Shay, how nerfed are his cards gonna be? Right? Because it says new characters, of course, Shay Obsidian, and then Akira Zizun, and then Spectre, both of which are from Vrains, which I haven't watched much of. right? So yeah, I haven't watched much of it. I think I've watched like the first two episodes of Rings. And if you're asking why, it's because, well, I've kind of got other things going on at the moment. Like my brain is not in where the anime is supposed to be. Yeah. I will get to it eventually, and then I can say that, you know what, whether these characters should be added or not. But Shay is definite. And here's how I think it should go. If they're going to give us Shay in December, right? And things we know for sure from the recent Dual Carnival, Dual Road, that at some point within the next year, I'm counting from December to December, we might or might not be getting either Vengex or Quinton for Zexal. I also know that we might be getting, like, all indicators point out that we're going to get Baron Wall characters. I'm hoping we get Baron Wall character, Baron Wall Shark. That would be nice. But it should be like a transformation, like how Zexal is a transformation for Yuma and Astral. That would be cool. But that being said, if you're going to get Shay in December, can we get like a Vrain's Wall character in January, and then in February we can like flip back to Arc 5 and get either Yuto or Yuri. Not Yuto, Yugo or Yuri, one of the two. I mean, Yugo's Speedroid card's already in the game. Can we get those? Yeah. Can we get those? I haven't checked if there's Starving Venom in Starving Venom in the game just yet. I will be checking that in a bit, like when I'm done here. Then maybe in March we can get the Baron Wall characters, or Vengex or Quinton. Preferably Quinton. The dual wheel on Zexal is already full. We don't need like any more characters like immediately. Can we fill up the character slots that we don't have? Like in Arc 5, and like focus on those worlds specifically for now. Like between now and April, that would be perfect. It would be 100% perfect if you guys could do that. Like seriously, Konami, do it. Focus on the wheels that y'all don't have. Because as I see this, I mean, it's not really a new character, is it? Like, this is going to be a hint towards a new character for Dark Side of Dimensions. But it's not going to be a new character just yet. Maybe we'll get a new character sometime next year. But we're not all cheesing for it. We're honestly not all cheesing for it at the moment. Yes, I did the survey. I did the survey at the beginning of the month, of the week. Yeah, we're not cheesing for a Dark Side of Dimensions character. Can we get, like, maybe, after Shay, can we get, like, either Yugo or Yuri for Arc 5, and then we can focus on Vrain's. There's more out to this. There's more characters that you guys could do outside of the thing. And I know what y'all trying to do, like trying to balance it where you'll give us one character and then another character from another series and then another character from another. Yeah, okay. But most of the dual wheels are full. They really are. If y'all want to add characters, add like Darts. Darts would be a really good addition to Dual Monsters. Night Shroud would be a really good addition to GX. Misty would be an excellent addition to 5Ds, and then Quinton would be a good addition to Zexal. Shay is very, 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 very great. I hope that we actually do get Shay this month, if not in January. But yeah, that's just my opinion. Whether Konami does it or not is on them. I'm hoping that they do. This leak came in on the 22nd, which was last week. And I haven't been on the meta for a while, so yeah, like I said, I've been busy with other stuff. So yeah. But hey, yo, those are just my opinions. Let me just close this advert. No, okay, there's no advert for me. There's no close button for me. But yeah, okay. Let's just keep it there. Yeah, that's just my opinion. We're gonna leave it there. That's just my opinion on who they should add in next and whether or not we get Shake. Because this will be very, very interesting. It, like it says, it's Vayne's character IDs are already here within the game. For Vayne's, I would actually hope, because of what I've been reading up on Vayne's, Spectre should be good. Spectre should be really, really good for Vayne's world. Akira, okay, maybe, yeah, sure. But this is the one we actually all do want to see. For Arc 5, that's the one we want to see. I'm sorry, apparently my page didn't open on the screen. I have no idea why. Let me see if it works again. Let me just close my recording software, like minimize it and then reopen it. And then go there. No, it's not working. It's not working. Let me do it from here. No, it's not working. Okay, cool. We'll discuss this, and I might re-record this video maybe later or on Monday, and we can discuss it then. Or we can discuss it tomorrow on the stream if you guys want to come along and watch me play Fortnite, and you can, like, hit me up in the chat. Right? If not, then, hey, cool. Just come and watch. We will discuss this at some other point in time when the characters do eventually pop up, you know what I'm saying? But hey, until then, guys, just remember to be nice to each other. Oh, don't forget to hit the like, subscribe, and comment down below. Also hit the bell notification, it lets you know when I upload a video. Until then, guys, just remember to be nice to each other, because being nice is free.